It goes without saying, 2019 was a stellar year for the series. Not only the anime was an outstanding success, but the growth of the franchise is incredible. It's practically the hottest thing in Japan and still going strong to 2020. Most importantly, the quality of its content remained top-notch. 2020 has begun, and it continues to present great moments with plenty to invest and fear. Before the chapter starts, the cover presents Nezuko in an exhausted state. The page alone brings a lot of interest. While she's still on her way to save Tanjiro, it appears she has slowed down, struggling with something. Close up to her face, it looks like the medicine may be in effect. In other words, she's converting back to human. Maybe. It's highly suggested with her veins popping only from her left side. It's as if to say, partial of her body converted to human, for a moment at least. Not to mention the fact she slowed down, whereas a demon has unlimited stamina is a sign of limitation, at least non-demon. It's possible that I may be looking at things incorrectly, red herring or misguided. Is it guaranteed the medicine will work? Only time will tell. Now, let's kick off to the chapter. Kakushi are patrolling the city to push away the civilians from danger. I appreciate this detail, because without it, it would have given an impression that the city is isolated. It would be like that film, where they flat out said everyone was gone because it is bedtime, so you can destroy all the buildings for fun. The only believable excuse is far less people are outside at night, in which this series used. The real takeaway, though, it's a cat with a mission. It was helped by them, and in hindsight, they deserve a lot of credit. The battle he saw with Obanai going all in on Muzan. After the last chapter with his backstory, I have grown concerns on his behalf. With that said, he does a really good job on holding him down. I like his swift maneuver to slice Muzan's limb off and kick it away immediately to slow down regeneration. That's some smart thinking, albeit suicidal. The sad thing is, it only brought him a moment of time. Croc-sensei is doing a really good job on making me appreciate more on Obanai after the last chapter. He points out the danger of Muzan's attacks, mainly on his mouth, which is terrifying itself. The part that got me respecting him more is his motivation for taking that risk. He knows it will only bring very little extra time, but he won't let the lives of many go in vain. He is paying their sacrifices for his dangerous yet helpful take. I seriously hope he survives. Speaking of survival, Giyu's struggle has my sympathy. He's clearly handicapped with a broken sword, but it can still be used to attack. Then he loses it due to his loss of his grip. His reaction has the look of complete defeat. His survival rate is very shaky, but I thought he was ready to take a fatal blow like Kanroji. Obanai once again shined as a nice fella, saving Giyu in time. Imashima also helped as well. To make the moment cooler, Sanami throws a sword to get him back to the fight. This whole moment made a corpse awesome to be part of. Just wish life risking wasn't on the brochure. Giyu's expression to grab the sword hits me. He's trying to recover mentally. It did pain me to see him this way. He's back on his feet, thankfully. Sadly, they have 1 hour and 14 minutes left until dawn. Hearing a timer never felt so disheartening since the film 1917. What's worse is everyone is poisoned, so their time is almost up. Time is truly the enemy. Luck will arrive, however. If you never own a pet, this chapter may give you an idea. The cat that was rescued earlier shows up with a backpack opening up, shooting out syringe. I like the realistic reaction of Giyu, thinking he's about to die. No one knows that cat, so feeling lost is understandable. Fortunately, it's on their side. Those syringes contain an antidote to the poison, eventually curing them for the time being. It's all thanks to Tamayo. I like how the dead can still torment the living, especially done by her. A better send-off that will benefit all for the greater good. Muzan is already hated for bringing all hell to everyone we love. The most logical approach to make Muzan even more hated is killing it. Not just killing it, but cut it into pieces. If you're a cat person, this would piss you off to the end of time. The cat has done more than the cast of another series I won't mention before I get steamrolled, enough to have everyone back up. Teamwork is a blessing feature. The cliffhanger leaves a promising note. Obunai acknowledges his lack of contribution, which is a bit concerning. Whenever a pillar think this way, they go for a more suicidal approach. With that said, there's a promising hope from the early revelation. As you can recall, Tokito made his blade turn red in his final move. It's on the record, and Obunai obtained the detail from the crow. It was said all Tokito did was strongly gripping his sword. Obunai goes for the same approach, and the last panel shows it works. Got to love his sinister expression. Although it's hopeful, I hope he doesn't pay his life in the process. This was a very good chapter with teamwork display and Obunai shine. The cat was MVP for saving everyone from pending death. Tamayo will be so proud. I'm liking Obunai more and more. Kudos to Croc Sensei. The action was pretty good. Not as intense as earlier, but it's likely to go full speed very soon. It's only a matter of time. The next chapter looks promising, but don't place your bet on hope alone. Otherwise, suffering will be your only friend. And that would do it for the review. I hope you enjoyed this one. I really hope Obunai survives. The last bit reminds me of another series, and I don't want to be reminded because in that series, well, it ended fatally. Do you think Obunai will survive? What do you think of this chapter? Share your thoughts in the comment section. If you like this and want more of this, subscribe to my channel, and my world will be yours to stay. Until next time, take care.